Hey, you want to save 20% off of everything in the store? Then show up on the 20th of every month, because the 20th is Founders Day here at Alternate Reality. And on Founders Day, everything except this week's new comics and bulk supplies is 20% off. That's right, every single thing in the store is 20% off every 20th here at Alternate Reality.
Now it's time for your fix of DC news.
After very careful consideration, sir, I've come to the conclusion that your system sucks.
DC Comic Book News, episode 28, The Squirt's Last Call.
Hey folks, how you doing? Comic Book Man here. Welcome to my video outhouse. It's time once again for DC Comic, look, Aquaman, DC Comics News. And joining me in the DC Comics room at Alternate Reality for DC Comics News is...
Bo, how are you? How are you feeling?
And the DC Comics room, which we're coming from, is at Alternate Reality, which is in Mount Greenwood in Chicago, Illinois, at the intersection of 111th and Kedzie. And you can come down here 6 days a week. I'm closed on Sundays. 6 days a week and get all your new DC Comics for... 15% off every day for everyone. And one of those comics was this. What's going on with Superman? I hear that people are being fired. Heads are rolling.
The ongoing legal saga between the Warner Brothers folks and the Siegel and Schuster relatives there resulted in the Warner Brothers people firing the law firm that was handling the case.
You're fired!
So what they did is they fired both of those law firms, and they hired Daniel Petrocelli, who was the guy who was basically the Yeah, Petrocelli. It was a hell of a show. And who actually represented the...
Oh, and you talk to me about references from the 60s and 70s. U.S.O.B. you. You talk to me. Yes, he was what?
Daniel was better known as basically representing the Goldman family, the O.J. Simpson civil suit.
Yes.
He also represented the Disney company in a lawsuit against Winnie the Pooh. The clock is still ticking on this. They got to get that Superman movie started. Started by the end of the year. The clock is ticking.
Why did they fire this? Why did they fire the one law firm?
Apparently, they didn't like two law firms, and they didn't like what they were doing. I guess they were going, we're losing. We're getting our asses kicked. Why don't we hire somebody else?
I thought Warner Communications had like two floors of lawyers who sit around and handle this stuff. They're going outside to hire
people. Apparently,
now
it's one floor.
Okay.
Lawyers cost money, you know.
Moving along, Wonder Woman 600 is rocketing your way. Yeah, I know it's 41, but they're going to do the same flippy thing with the numbers that Marvel's been doing for the last 5 or 6 years, which nobody seems to have a problem with. So when you start bitching about it, Marvel's been doing it for 4 or 5 years now.
That's what I do when I number the episode.
Gail Simone is leaving Wonder Woman with issue a 600.
Yes.
And she will be replaced by J. Michael Straczynski, who's also taking over Superman with issue 701.
That's what I've heard.
So now if you think about this, if Straczynski's writing Wonder Woman and Superman, Brave and the Bold, toast.
Cross-dressing.
Toast.
Well, not necessarily.
He can't write three books a month.
Straczynski on Brave and the Bold is toast, but he didn't come on the book until issue 25 or 26.
But he's supposed to be the savior.
The book will carry on from... Well, if he's been the savior, he's done a crack-up. He's done a crack-up job. And I like Straczynski. Flash news. What's going on with Geoff Johns and the Flash? This book is coming out at some point. Actually, I think it's coming out this week.
That's because he's finally got the limited series finished.
This book's coming out this week.
It took longer, but the first issue will basically define who the character is and why Barry Allen does what he does. He also said the Rogue is going to be a major part of the book and that he's created new villains, one of which is the most twisted villain ever seen in Flash history.
The Rogues?
The Rogues.
Yes.
Apparently the Rogues...
You said the Rogue.
The Rogues are going to be very important in the DC Universe, which I'm assuming has something to do with the ending of Blackest Night.
Possibly.
Could be.
Possibly.
Something big's happening.
Okay. Big. So that's the Flash. Big. Next up we got... Oh, Red Robin. Red Robin. He's got... Isn't that a line of hot dog hamburger stores?
Yes. It's actually a chain of hamburgers.
So he's going to start...
Are quite tasty.
He's going to start grilling burgers very soon, coming to you.
No, he's not.
Red Robin.
Fabian DeCesa, who basically ended Tim Brake's run as Robin and turned the book to Fabian DeCesa.
Who ended what?
He ended Tim Brake's run as Robin to set up the Red Robin book.
Yes.
Now, Fabian will be coming back and take over Red Robin with issue 13. So he's coming back to the area which he's more comfortable with. Christopher Yost has been basically moved on to another book.
Here's a bulletin from the newsroom. It is being reported that Free Comic Book Day will be returning on the first Saturday in the month of May. As they have in the past, Alternate Reality, located in Mount Greenwood, will once again be participating. To repeat, Free Comic Book Day is returning on May the 1st, and Alternate Reality will once again be participating. We will, of course, break back in if there are any updates to the story. We now return to our regularly scheduled programming.
Why wasn't he comfortable with where he was?
Who, Fabian DeCesa or Red Robin?
You said he was more comfortable there.
Fabian? Well, yes, yeah, it's sure. a character. He's, Fabian Esaias has been writing Robin, Nightwing, Tim Drake, Dick Grayson for about, what, 5-6 years now?
Okay, and he hasn't been comfortable where he's been?
Well, he's been doing nothing. DC's been, like, moving him from spot to spot. And so they said, why don't you come back to the character you really like working on? He said, oh, sure, what the hell of an idea.
That's called exposition, folks. It's like pulling teeth. It really is. Last story
I
we got.
I made all that up.
I don't know if we've ever told you this, but none of this news is true.
It's true!
Make it all up.
The end
make
part. Make it all up.
Last story we got, Power Girl. This part of Power Girl and this part of Power Girl are getting their own miniseries. No. And they're going to be called Boobalicious.
It was announced...
Power Girl Boobalicious!
It was announced basically a day or so ago that Jimmy Palmiotti,
yes.
Justin Gray, and Amanda yes. Conner are going to be leaving this book with number 12 because oh. Amanda Conner said, I can't do another year on the book. Now, they already know...
Sweet Dan Sweet's going to be pissed off because he loves this book.
They already know who's replacing them. They won't reveal it yet, but DC said they're going to reveal that information probably before March the 21st. So as you're watching this, when it gets posted up, we may know who's taking over the book, and if you haven't watched it or you haven't read it anywhere, we'll let you know.
We will.
But they said the company... Yeah, we will. On the news. It'll be on the news. It'll be updated. And Palmiotti, Gray, and Conner said the new people replacing them are really, really cool.
Who are the new people replacing
them? They won't say.
Oh. Big secret, huh?
Yeah.
Why don't you make up some names and just tell people?
It's gonna
Stanley!
Be
Stanley's going to be the new writer.
Harlan Ellison, Neil Adams, and Vinnie Coletta.
You heard it here first.
I'm taking over the book.
You heard it here first.
William Shakespeare's going to write
William Shakespeare's going to edit it.
He's Shakespeare's going to do half the books, half the issues, and
you know. He thinks my boobs are too big.
How
do
you see William put the other half?
And then the following year, John Grisham, Stephen King, and Dennis Lehane are taking over the book.
Wow.
Okay, so that's it. We're done with DC News. There's no more DC News this time around, but you can read more DC News at the store's website.
Can we
and where is the store's website at?
Sarah knows.
Sarah's going to make this up, too.
This is just to keep me busy, isn't it?
Yes.
www.myalternaterealty.com.
Cool.
So stop off at the store's website and check out all the DC news that Einstein here sends
makes
me,
that
May makes up, that I post up
I'm
at the
making
store.
It up right now.
And Bo has a special request that he has of all of our Facebook and Outhouse viewers
Bo,
right now.
Implore them.
Now, I have started basically taking the videos that I'm involved in with this young man onto my Facebook account. But if you're on there, please make comments. If you like something, you don't like something, say something. We
afraid.
Know you're out there. It's nice if we're going to hunt you down and kill you because we don't like what you say. Post a comment.
So you're putting these on your Facebook page now.
Yes, I am.
We've been doing this for over a year. You've had your Facebook account for 2 years.
Yes.
You just got around to doing this now.
It's easier to hook it up.
This man.
That cable modem.
Man,
it happened so fast. It's amazing.
This man is brilliant. He's absolutely brilliant. I should do that myself. Oh, wait a minute. I have been doing that.
You don't have a cable modem?
Anyway, that's it. We're done. We're finished right here. Until next time, this is Comic Man.
And Bo.
Saying bye. It's a new month here at Alternate Reality, and that means a new Hero of the Month sale. And this month, we're featuring superheroines. That's right, all my superheroine trades are 25% off all month long. Now, which superheroines are you talking about? Birds of Prey, Catwoman, Supergirl, Spider-Girl, Batgirl, Elektra, Catwoman, Hellcat, and many, many more are all 25% off here at Alternate Reality all month long. Alternate Reality is located at 3149 West 111th Street. That's the intersection of 111th and Kedzie in Chicago, the beautiful downtown Mount Greenwood neighborhood. You can always reach us at 773-881-HERO or at the store's website, www.myalternatereality.com.